In this video, I will talk about rock, paper, scissors, which is a two-person zero-sum game with no settle point. Then I will show you how to formulate it as a linear programming problem using mixed strategies. In a previous video titled Two-Person Zero-Sum Game and Pure Strategy, I showed that not all two-person constant sum games have settle points using pure strategies. A pure strategy means a player always chooses the same strategy every time he or she plays a game. To solve such problems, we need to consider mixed strategies. A mixed strategy means a player chooses each strategy with a certain probability. For a player with n possible strategies, a mixed strategy is x1, x2 through xn, and x1 plus x2 plus through xn is equal to 1. If any of the probability is equal to 1, then the mixed strategy becomes a pure strategy. Let's see an example. Two players are playing the rock, paper, and scissors game. They must simultaneously utter one of the three words, rock, paper, and scissors, and show corresponding hand signs. If both players utter the same word, then the game is a tie. Otherwise, one player wins $1 from the other player according to the following rules. Scissors defeats paper, paper defeats rock, and rock defeats scissors. Find the optimal strategies for this two-person zero-sum game. This is the payoff matrix. If player 1 plays rock and player 2 plays rock, it is tie and player 1 wins $0. If player 1 plays rock and player 2 plays paper, player 1 loses $1. If player 1 plays rock and player 2 plays scissors, player 1 wins $1 and so on. For each row, the minimum value is negative 1, so the max min is just a negative 1. For each column, the maximum value is positive 1. So the min max is just positive 1. There's no settle point because negative 1 is not equal to positive 1. That means the pure strategy does not work for this example. Let's try the mixed strategy. Let x1, x2, and x3 be the probabilities that player 1 chooses rock, paper, and scissors respectively. Let y1, y2, and y3 be the probabilities that player 2 chooses rock, paper, and scissors respectively. Now player 1 should decide the values of x1, x2, and x3. If player 2 plays rock, then the expected payoff for player 1 is x1 times 0 plus x2 times positive 1 plus x3 times negative 1. If player 2 plays paper, then the expected payoff for player 1 is x1 times negative 1 plus x2 times 0 plus x3 times positive 1. If player 2 plays scissors, then the expected payoff for player 1 is x1 times positive 1 plus x2 times negative 1 plus x3 times 0. Player 1 knows that player 2 will choose a strategy that makes player 1's expected payoff equal to the smallest one of these three. That means the minimum value of these three. So player 1 should choose x1, x2, and x3 to make the minimum value as large as possible. Let's give the minimum value of these three to V. Because player 1 should make V as large as possible, it is a maximization problem. Because V is the smallest value of these three, so V should be less than or equal to each of them. The sum of the probabilities is 1. The decision variables x1, x2, and x3 are probabilities, so they are all between 0 and 1. V is unrestricted in sign. Now player 2 should decide the values of y1, y2, and y3. If player 1 plays rock, then his expected payoff is y1 times 0 plus y2 times negative 1 plus y3 times positive 1. If player 1 plays paper, then his expected payoff is y1 times positive 1 plus y2 times 0 plus y3 times negative 1. If player 1 plays scissors, then his expected payoff is y1 times negative 1 plus y2 times positive 1 plus y3 times 0. Player 2 knows that player 1 will choose a strategy to ensure that he obtains an expected payoff equal to the largest one of these three. That means the maximum value of these three. So player 2 should choose y1, y2, and y3 to make the maximum value as small as possible. Let's give the maximum value of these three to W. Because player 2 should make W as small as possible, it is a minimization problem. Because W is the largest value of these three, so W should be greater than or equal to each of them. The sum of the probabilities is 1. The decision variables y1, y2, and y3 are probabilities, so they are all between 0 and 1. W is unrestricted in sign. Here we have player 1's linear programming formulation and player 2's linear programming formulation. It turns out that player 2's linear programming formulation is the dual of player 1's linear programming formulation. Therefore, the optimal solution is V star is equal to W star, which is the value of the game to player 1. This is the relation between player 1's linear programming formulation and player 2's linear programming formulation. We can solve the problems using the simplex algorithm. The optimal solution is V star is equal to W star is equal to 0. The optimal strategy for player 1 is 1/3 of the time he should play rock, 1/3 of the time he should play paper, and 1/3 of the time he should play scissors. The optimal strategy for player 2 is the same. The optimal solution of a mixed strategy is called a mixed strategy Nash equilibrium. Okay, that is the rock, paper, scissors game and mixed strategies. Thanks for watching.